Vista. A new parliament building will be celebratory if all have access to health and prosperity. Laying the foundation for a new parliament building for India should be a celebratory occasion, one that every citizen would proudly claim as another edifice of a thriving democracy. So recently the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, has decided to build another new parliament for India. And this is obviously a proud moment for every citizen in India, and everyone is all obviously very excited for the great edifice. Edifice means the great building. It is an opportunity for record reflecting a pluralistic and progressive ethos. So it is an opportunity for accord, reflecting a pluralistic. So this new parliament building should be of great power, and it should reflect all the states in India, all the citizens in India. And this is obviously a progressive step towards the obviously a progressive step towards the development of India. Here they use the word ethos, means ethos means a character or spirit. If the development of the new parliament would show India as a progressive ethos or progressive character. Yet the ceremony is now poised to take place under the shadow of litigation, with the Supreme Court allowing the event to be held but temporarily restraining the central government from making site alterations in the form of additions and demolitions of structures and continued removal of trees. So if the central government wants to build this edifice, then they obviously need the permission of Supreme Court, and Supreme Court had partially agreed to the construction of this great edifice. It had some conditions that they should not be changing the sites of the construction frequently, because if they do so by adding extra structures and taking some structures away, it could be a waste of land, which in turn means a waste of trees. The new building, which is the part of Narendra Modi's government's ambitious plan to modify the central visa skyline of Lutyens, Delhi, will cost an estimated 971 crores and be able to accommodate a much larger number of MPs, 888 in Lok Sabha and 384 in Rajya Sabha. So this new edifice or building, which is a part of the Narendra Modi's government, which is a part of the central government's plan. The cost of this construction will estimatedly cost over 971 crores. And because the cost is much bigger, even the space or the region which the building will occupy will also be big. And because of that, even the MPs or the politicians who could fit in there also will be high number. For example, now the number of MPs which could be fit into the new parliament would be 888 members. And 888 members only from Lok Sabha, and from Rajya Sabha 384 members could be fit. Just weeks ago, the Housing and the Urban Affairs Ministry said the overall cost of redevelopment of the central vista had not been calculated, but the plan is estimated to run into thousands of crores, involving, among other things, a new central secretariat and the offices and the residences of the vice president and the prime minister. So the exact amount, the exact cost of this whole construction or this development process was not yet calculated, but it was estimated that the cost of this construction or development would be about thousands of crores. And the main reason is that this construction does not only involve only the parliament, it involves the office of vice president, president, prime minister, and so on. An epochal project, timed for completion ahead of the 75th anniversary of independence in 2022, it presents a rare moment to involve citizens and build a consensus. So this great project, it was estimated that this project will be completed before the independence day in the next year, and that Independence Day would make the 75th anniversary of India's independence. So hopefully if we complete the construction by that time, it would be achievement to celebrate on the Independence Day. But the government is now pressing ahead at a cheerless time when the country remains dismayed over a slowing economy and a double blow of the COVID-19 pandemic. And all these things are happening in a very bad situation. All these good things, the 75th anniversary of the independence of India, and also the construction of the great edifice. So all these great things are happening at a moment of distress, which was caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. It is reasonable to assume that even with a strong revival of the economy in a post-vaccine era, the debilitation cannot be easily overcome. So it is reasonable, means it is very obvious that even though the COVID-19 pandemic deteriorates, it doesn't mean that our economy will regain its health back up immediately. It will take some time. So because of that, it might even be a problem to construct the great edifice, because it costs over 1,000 crores. The government's interventions so far have largely been to encourage private consumption and modest revival of business, while its own consumption expenditure during the first half of the year has been below that of the corresponding period in the previous year. So the main thing that the government was saying since the starting of the pandemic, was supporting the private consumption. It means that it was supporting the people to spend more on the things. So that the center would get more money, and which could in turn help us in building a new India, which could potentially fight against the COVID-19 pandemic. And the irony is that even the government spendings or GDP or the India's GDP in the first half of this year was lesser than the GDP which we got in the previous year. This effect ensured the persistence of significant GDP contraction. And as I mentioned, GDP was decreased. So they said the same thing again. And because of that, our GDP decreased. Even on the question of a free COVID-19 vaccine, the government has been prevaricating with no assurance of universal vaccination. And also, as we all know, the Indian government or the central government is saying all the time that India will soon get a vaccine, but the global evidence is that not a single vaccine was actually tested, actually passed all the phase 3 trials. With concerns over allocation of resources, it cannot be anyone's case that the shining new central vista structures will add to the luster of an independence jubilee. So we may all think that if I get a new parliament, everyone would be happy, but not really, because if thousands of crores get spent on a great edifice which we all would happily need, but that's not the immediate need that we have now. The immediate need that we have now is to repair all the dents in India which have been exposed by the COVID-19 vaccine. And after that, it would be very safe to build the edifice. There are also indications that the center's PWD is trying to modify the overall redevelopment plan on the go, introducing changes piecemeal after getting approvals which the expert appraisal committee has frowned upon. In a year of unprecedented distress, therefore, what is seen as grand may appear grandiose to strike insurgents who need every rupee to stabilize their lives. So, yes, exactly. In a year of unprecedented distress, this year, the all citizens and all the people of India experienced unprecedented distress. So that the distress which was experienced by citizens of India and all people of India in this year was unprecedented. Means it was the means India did not witness this much distress since a long time. And because of that, the citizens would be all obviously be very stricken, or they would be very mad. And if the government spends thousands of crores on building a construction instead of repairing the dents in India, which have been aggravated by the COVID-19 pandemic, the citizens would obviously be mad at the government. They would be justified in asking the government why the house cannot be beautified after essential repairs have been made to India in order to render it safe. And now the citizens are asking the government that could you please postpone this event or activity of this construction after the economy and the infrastructure of India gets restored. So then it would indicate a safe play for India. The weakest link exposed by the pandemic is the healthcare, and the 75th anniversary should be an occasion to guarantee that a new parliament could then be built to celebrate such an achievement. So the weakest link in the Indian infrastructure was the healthcare system, and that was exposed by this COVID-19 pandemic. So as I said, in the next year we are having our Independence Day on August 15th. And that Independence Day is the 75th anniversary of India. So, as achievements to celebrate that day, we could start the construction of the new parliament and also we could restore the system of healthcare and make it if possible even make it a bit better. So all of these would be achievements to celebrate on the great Independence Day. Thank you.